How do you count unauthorized immigrants in Europe? In the last few years, Europe has seen a surge of migrants arriving on its shores seeking asylum, mostly from the Middle East and Africa. Not all have received asylum status, but some have stayed in Europe unlawfully, joining many immigrants already living illegally in the region. But just how many unauthorized migrants are there in Europe? Immigrants who are in a country without authorization often want to remain hidden due to their status, which adds the challenge of collecting data about them. Because of these hurdles, there hasn't been a comprehensive estimate of their total population in Europe for about a decade. This is why we at the Pew Research Center applied our more than 15 years of expertise in measuring the number of unauthorized immigrants in the United States to the populations in Europe. And based on different methods used, we estimate that at least 3.9 million and at most 4.8 million unauthorized immigrants lived in European Union and European Free Trade Association countries in 2017. Before we explain how we got this range, let's first define unauthorized immigrants. Our estimates count individuals coming from outside EU-FTA countries now living in Europe without authorization. This includes those who entered Europe without authorization, rejected asylum seekers, and others who entered lawfully but overstayed visas. Also counted in our estimates are the 1 million asylum seekers living in Europe in 2017 who are waiting for decisions on their cases. Many entered Europe without authorization, and it's uncertain if they will be allowed to stay. So how did we estimate 3.9 to 4.8 million unauthorized immigrants in Europe? Because of differences in data available in each of the 32 countries, we use four different methods: a residual method, a demographic components method, a regularization method, and a proportional ratio method. These were some of the same approaches used by European researchers about 10 years ago for the Clandestino project, which estimated the number of irregular immigrants in Europe at that time. We also consulted with more than 25 researchers, including many from that project, to help us better understand the data and best method for each country. Let's describe those four methods. First is a residual method, which is a tried and true approach we've used for many years to make our US estimates. In the case of Europe, it helped us calculate about 60% of our total unauthorized immigrant population. Using government data, we developed an estimate of the total non-citizen population within each of these countries. Then, we subtracted the authorized immigrant total in each to arrive at our estimate of the country's unauthorized immigrant population. We also made adjustments for potential undercounts, since unauthorized immigrants aren't always fully represented in country data. When data within a country doesn't allow for a residual method, a demographic components method is a good backup. This was the case for Italy and Greece, where we took 2008 estimates of the unauthorized immigrant population and then added new asylum seekers, like those from the recent surge and births. Then we subtracted those who gained authorization, deaths, and those who may have left the country. For Spain, where an active program allows unauthorized immigrants to gain lawful residency after 3 years in the country, a regularization method worked best. Here we add historical and projected data on the number of people accepted through that program to the number of waiting asylum seekers. For the proportional ratio method, we looked at estimates from a comparison country where the other methods were successful, took its ratio of unauthorized immigrants to authorized immigrants, and applied that ratio to the country at hand. Our numbers are an important baseline for understanding the volume and characteristics of unauthorized immigrants that have moved into and throughout Europe in recent years. And as the discussion surrounding immigration continues, these estimates will provide an important comparison for the future.